Here I have a world, and I'd like to add some water to it. Here's how I go about doing so. Now, in order to make water that looks nice and convincing, we will want to use a water shader. Some water shaders look absolutely stunning, while others are made to run more efficiently at the cost of visuals. Because of this, you may want to spend some time finding the shader that works best for your world. We do, however, need to make sure that the water shader we are using is VR compatible, as not all Unity shaders are. Now, a great place to find shaders for VRChat is by going to VRC Prefabs database. On the spreadsheet, we want to hit the Shaders tab, and then we can go Control F to search, and I'm going to search water. Now, I'm going to use Silent's Clear Water Shader in this tutorial, but some other great ones to mention are Red Sim's quote-unquote perfect water shader, Wacom Malt's Waco Water, and if you want it to be Quest compatible, Naughty Bean's Quest Water Shader is a pretty good option. Also, if you're after flowing water for an indoor river, water fountain, or the likes, Tsunamo's flowing water shader looks pretty good, though I don't really have a setup to show it properly. Finally, if you're after some underwater effects, I believe Red Sim's Pro version is pretty good, but I haven't used it myself, so I can't say. Now, coming back to Silent's Clear Water Shader, I want to hit this download link, and it will send us to its GitHub. Now, this shader doesn't come as a Unity package, but instead it's just a bunch of files. We want to hit this download symbol and download a zip file copy of it. Then, once it's downloaded, all that's left is to extract the file with your program of choice, be it WinRAR or 7-Zip. Now that we have our file, we first want to open up Unity and come to the project window and select the folder that will store our shader. Now, come back to Windows Explorer, we want to find where we extracted the shader to and drag and drop it into the project window. Give it a sec to install, and we have now installed a water shader. Now, you may want to rename and move some of these folders around later, but for now, we want to go to Clearwater Master, Shader, Clearwater, and now we'll see some shader files as well as two example materials to get us started. So, I now want to create an object to put this example water material on, so I'm going to go to my hierarchy and right-click 3D Object Plane. I'm then going to rename it to Water, and then I'm going to adjust its position as well as scale it up to fill up the map. Now, I just want to drag and drop one of these example water materials onto my plane, and now we have some water. Awesome! Now, we can click on our material here and adjust its values to better fit the scene. But just a word of caution. You can easily ruin the settings here beyond the point of return, so do make a backup of your material before you change anything by clicking on your material and going Control D to duplicate. Anyways, hope that this has been helpful for you. Feel free to leave a like on the video if you liked it, leave a comment down below if you have any questions, and feel free to check out some of my other tutorials that I have on the channel. But until next time, bye!